Alright. Welcome again to Gusti Data Channel. Yeah, today I just wanna share about little bit a few tips. Yeah, a few tips about Territory Recovery Mode. Territory Recovery Mode is one of the DLC, the newest DLC for this game, Attack on Titan 2. So when you buy the DLC Final Battle, Territory Recovery Mode will be included, and here where your grinding game begin. Okay, in this Territory Recovery Mode, you have to do many things. So you get the secret skills here, you will get the golden drops to upgrade your skill points here, and you can unlock some characters, and the card titans will be here. Okay, the first tips before you do any mode, include the territory recovery mode. Yeah, you have to go to the system option and then change the difficulty to be heaven. Okay, why heaven? I will show you later. Okay, first change to be that, and then you start the territory recovery mode. If you are the first timer of for playing the territory recovery mode, I suggest you to choose Levi if you are a blood user, or Kenny if you are a gunner or a firearm user. For me, I used Kenny before. If you can see my previous video for that. And then after that, you will be come to the plaza like this, and there is no statue, nothing at all in here. You have to play from zero. And then your squad will be like this. Why you have to choose Kenny? Because later when you level up Kenny, if you use Kenny, yeah, the level 15 of Kenny will have the default skill as a firearms user, like the advanced ODM skills, point blank, extra bullets, and constant and reload ace, yeah, which is really helpful as a firearm user. But if you use Levi, if you use Levi before for a first time for playing the territory recovery mode, the best skill for the default skill later after level 15 of Levi will have Wings of Freedom, which is really crucial as a blade user, spinning slash, and then the high stats of the character. Levi and Kenny has the high stats, and you can play along the way and then upgrade the stats later along the game after you experience the game. Yeah. Okay. As this one, remember when you first timer for the playing the territory recovery mode, you will become only these two characters, and then you have to play some mission as a tutorial. Okay, and after that you go back to the plaza. After you got back to plaza, what you need to remember, what you need to concern to, is the war room. In the war room, in here, yeah, in the war room, you have to go to this woman. Okay, after you play the mission again and again and again, go back here and expand your base, yeah, expand your base. And then for this one residential district, if you upgrade it, you can recruit more cadets to your squad. And then if you upgrade plaza, you get more turns or more supplies, so you can do more mission later in the expedition. And then for war room, in here you can put the like this possession personnel to be 12, like this to be 12. Yeah, this is the it will be need later lah. And then this one, the last thing you need to upgrade, because it's not kinda not too crucial, it is the latest one you have to upgrade. Okay, so the very first one you need is this, because you need to recruit many cadets so you get more power and something like that, and skills. Yeah, you have to farming that. And then the other things, the turns or the supplies, so you can do the mission again and again frequently, more frequently. Okay. And then for this war room, it will be come to this. position personnel. It will become has 12 slot like this. So you can put before, yeah, before you have something like this, your squad will be like A at the best of their aptitude. So make sure this one, the clean up squad, has the best one, and then just a moment. And then the operation squad, yeah. Because when you play the territory recovery mode, you have to use the policy clean up squad, or maybe the battle analysis, or maybe the discipline, yeah. And then this one will give you more level up when you would like to recruit the cadets. The experience you will get will be more better for the comrade level. So make sure to use to put many people in here and here, so your policy can be affect more for more turns. Yeah. So for the policy here, in here, the policy here, you have to this one usually use, yeah, recognition and discipline. This is for use for getting more money, and then this one intensive cleaning week to get more comrade level, and then the Wings of Freedom points. So only that two is really important. Okay, and then after you expand the base, yeah, after you expand the war room until level 5 and residential district until level 5, you will unlock name is recruit volunteer. In here the distress call here, you will unlock recruit volunteers, which is recruit volunteers are really needed when you would like to get another cadet. If you don't find any because the sums of the cadets will be here, like the Kenny, like the Pixies, yeah, and many more. So you have to use the recruit volunteer here, yeah. And like Eren Longhair will be there in the recruit volunteer. So make sure you unlock that and recruit them to your squad. Okay, until that is already understood, yeah. Okay, so after that, don't worry, you can recruit your custom character later after you finish some missions and back to the plaza. Your character will be in here in this around plaza. So make sure you recruit your custom character later, ya. Yeah? And the other things, when you choose the Heaven difficulty, like I said before, you will get the benefit like this one. Infinite items, so you can equip the items again and again. No need to worry about your health too, because when you grab by the titans, your health will not be decreased and you will not be in the red or danger situation. So when you play territory recovery mode for the first time with the Heaven mode, it is really easy to play and to recruit the characters, to do farming. It will be easy. Even though it is not fast, but easy, okay. And then the other tips will be what you need to get the skills, yeah. The skills that you need to get, you have to organize your character better. Before I play this one, my concern is how to get the elimination bounty skills and the other crucial skills. So for if you use Levi as the player, as the character, your skill that you got from the story mode will be not used here. You have to use the free skill. The free skill means that that skill can only be used by the custom the other character, not your custom character. So it will be like this for Levi, like here, So the free skill that he will get, it's based on the like this. I'll show you. Wait a moment. Yeah, this one. This free skill, if you level up the comrade level between Levi and Mitabi to level 3, to rank 3 of comrade, yeah. Your character, not custom character, yeah. It will be other character, will get the free skill named Mid-Air Blade Swap. Your custom character cannot use this skill, but your Levi or maybe Kenny or maybe Mikasa later can use these skills. Remember, free skill is different than the skill that you will get from story mode. So you have to grinding again here. Remember to put the squad here, like here, Bertolt. For me, for Bertolt, you have to get Bertolt fast. And then kids, where is kids? Yeah, kids, and then the other things, maybe Mikasa or maybe ZK, yeah. Why ZK? Let's see the comrade level. So when you level up the comrade level between ZK and then Levi, there is nothing. So in here, no. Yeah, it's better to put Armin, yeah. Armin with Zeki or Levi with this one, Levi with, yeah, this one. Levi with Zeki, you will get the skill Wings of Freedom, which is this skill can be used by another character, but not your custom character. For your custom character to get this skill, you have to level up Levi to level 10. Remember, it is different. The skill that you will get from the story mode, from upgrade character, for upgrade the comrade level will be different. Remember that. Okay. If it's named free skill, Wings of Freedom, it means its skills only special for other character except your custom character. So the custom character, you have to grinding again. You can see the detail of the skill in my video about the free skill, about the character custom skill, so you can see that on my videos for that. Okay, remember to put it like this. For me here, like this, because the comrade level, if you see Bertolt, I will show you, yeah, Bertolt here, Bertolt, and then the kids, where is it, kids? Okay, it's not here. So kids and Bertolt, yeah. Kids and Bertolt. Okay, kids and Bertolt. Yeah, this one. It will get free skill Elimination Bounty. Okay. Elimination Bounty is really crucial skill for me and for us all. You have to get it first. This one free skill. But if you'd like to get the skill Elimination Bounty for your custom character, you have to level up Bertolt, this one, custom character with kids, okay? Your custom character and kids. So we'll get skill Elimination Bounty. You see the different free skill and skill. Skill means for your custom character, free skill for other characters. Okay, until there, understand, right? Okay. So for this squad, you can put maybe ZK change to be your custom character. So you can get free skill for Levi and the skill for your custom character later. For Inferno maybe. Okay. So that's it. Okay. So after it is become like this, yeah. After you check the deployed squad like this, and then already rank 5, change the squad, the member squad here, to another character. It's better to level up the comrade level with all of the character like this, so you get all the skills, all the free skills, all the awakening points for the characters. So it is really really needed if you'd like to level up your favorite character to the max. or maybe your custom character to the max. Remember, if you would like this territory recovery mode will unlock the secret of your custom character. You see, if you use your custom character in here, this one, the stats can be 120, right? It because you have to unlock in here. In this territory recovery mode, you have to play, and then you have to level up the comrade level, your custom character, with all the character to level 5. Why? Because if you see here, the custom character with Eren on the rank 5 of the comrade level will unlock hand-to-hand combat training. It will be uncapped. Okay? Uncapped. So when you go to the story mode, after you level up the comrade level, go back to the story mode. Go back to the story mode, yeah. And then you go to the training ground. Just a moment. Quite loading. Okay, and then to the training area, to the training ground, yeah. And then you go here and do the training, the solo training. So your training level can be to be 2 stars like this. Before you, it will be no stars, yeah. If you don't play the territory recovery mode, it will be no star here. So your custom character will be still weak. So if you'd like to upgrade the stats like this, do the training here. But you have to level up the comrade level between all the characters in between your characters and all other characters. So you can uncap all the stats and then train them to the max to 120. Okay, that is for the custom character. So remember, after you play for some times and you would like to get more power, what you need to go after you get all the things, yeah, remember what you need for the to go to Inferno. Remember, don't go to the Inferno of the story mode yet, because your custom character is still weak. Just play in the territory recovery mode, and then you have to play in the here. When you finish all the mission, the territory recovery mode, you will unlock this man in the middle of the plaza. Ask this man and go to the from normal to Inferno. But remember, don't go to Inferno if you don't recruit all the cadets and get the crucial skill. What is the crucial skills? The crucial skill that you will need, I change to be Kenny, and then I will unequip for the skills that the non-default skill, yeah. I will unequip it for you, so you will see which skill that you need only. So you don't need to use all of them. I know that because the skill points that you will have later will be very limited, so you cannot equip all the skills. But after you level up the comrade level for Kenny with the other characters, Kenny will have more skill points and Kenny can use more skills. Same like Levi. If Levi has level up the comrade level with all other characters, Levi can equip more skills. Okay, it will be like this. So Kenny, when level up the comrade level like this, when level up comrade level with Eren, on rank 1 with get skill points, rank 3 skill points, and rank 5 one more skill points, it will be comes to here, to the right side over there. It is not 999 before, yeah. It will be still low. Of course, it's still low. And then after you level up the comrade level from Kenny with the other characters, You can equip the skills and remember you have to get the free skills, that crucial one that you have to equip. It is multi dash. Okay, remember multi dash. Air move. And then this one is not yet. Item master 1, 2, 3, very crucial. Okay. Decisive battle. Okay. This one. Elimination bounty. And then just one more, which is this one, yeah. Where is it? Which is back to from the brink actually. Yeah, this one. Oh sorry, this one. And medicine in the mid air. Oh, which is this one. Mid air first aid. Only 59 of skill points, you can go to the Inferno. Remember, before to go Inferno, the skill is equipped, and then the items that you need to bring, which is the battle alert signal, backup signal, and distress signal. And then the equipment should be plus 99 or plus 99 star is okay, and then upgrade it to the latest stage that you can. And then you can go to Inferno of the Territory Recovery Mode. In the Territory Recovery Mode of the Inferno difficulty, you can go there and then get the materials to further upgrade your equipment to the max. Remember? In this, after that, you finish all the Inferno there. Finally, you will get to the Eden difficulty. In here, where your life will be easier. Because in Eden mode, when you finish the mission for the first time in the Eden difficulty, you will get golden drops, which is will upgrade or level up your skill points here to be 999, and you can equip all the skills that you have got before, like this. All the skills can be equipped. So that's it. Okay, and if you play the 6-star or the 6 stars of above mission in the Eden difficulty of the Territory Recovery Mode, you will get the golden drops again. Remember to equip elimination bounty skills so you get 20 of the golden drops when you finish the mission. Alright, I think that's all for the tips in this Attack on Titan 2 Final Battle Territory Recovery Mode. So if you need anything, just call, or just not call, just contact me or maybe comment. I will try to help you as much as I can. And then remember to training to the war room, upgrade it, and then expand your base so you can recruit more grinding of level up the comrade level. It's all about grinding in this game. What you need, really need, what you really really need in this game: patience and effort. There is no pay to win here. If you are good, you are good. If you are not, you are not. What you need is the will to slaughter the titans. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. Hopefully you are become super powerful, very OP, and see you on next video. Bye bye.